Hello everyone, welcome back. It is the final look into this week's Try On Tuesday session. We have gone through lots of gorgeous knitwear, tops, trousers, dresses, all encompassing this fabulous 50 Shades of Grey theme. I am just living for this last look. I wanted to keep this one till the end because I know I just kind of come up with so many different ways to wear. So again, it's all about that layered feeling and in the softest of grey tones. And I'm loving grey myself this year. I had been off grey for a long time, but I think because I've embraced that highlighted grey hair, I feel I can do these cooler tones a little bit easier. And oh my God, the versatility. All of you who've been in grey for all these years, how did I not know? I just think it's such a nice neutral colour and it's really a great blank canvas for lots of other colours. So useful. I'm so excited to be in the new world of grey now. So final look, and today I'm showing you almost head to toe Maasai. So this came in a little while ago and I have been kind of playing with it in my mind in terms of styling. And today it came to me. It's going in with the greys and it is just sitting so perfectly here with a little bit of pop of white as well. So we have two pieces in the same fabric. This is the Nola dress and then we have the Pira culotte. So we have this beautiful wool blend, I think. Again, haven't checked this first. So 50% wool and 50% polyester. So nice little mix here. This is the Nola dress. It is a sleeveless dress with a V-neck or a kind of more of a U-neck. It's a soft V and it's sleeveless obviously. So it has little slits at the ends as well and it's in A shape tight. So I think because it's more of a wool base, it's done in the tight rather than the loose. So that it gives you a nice fitted, tailored shape, but you still have, you know, lots of room. As ever with Maasai, it's always done with that generous kind of silhouette in mind. So I'll come back to this beautiful scarf as well, another piece from Maasai. So here is the dress. Now, of course, you could wear this on its own. And this is again where I would bring in the tights and the grey boots again. So in this one, I mean, you could choose, it could be a dark, I would try and tend to match my footwear to the tights. So if I had a darker grey boot, I would stick with the darker grey tights. If I had a lighter grey boot, I would go with the lighter grey tights. And you can see how the grey with the grey is going to be a lot soft, more soft than adding black. I had, tried this on with black boots and black tights and all that as well, and it still works really nicely, but you have to keep in mind the layer underneath here, so it must incorporate a little bit of black. If you're going to have black at the ends coming out, you need to have it up top as well. It could be a mixed print black, it doesn't have to be solid black, but I already showed you black in the first look, so I wanted to bring in a little bit of a fresher, lighter palette. And also just to show you, you don't have to be in dark colours for the winter time if you don't want to be either. You know I'm a lover of black, so black is always my go-to, but if it's not black, it's usually white. So the dress, obviously, you could wear it on its own, as I was saying, with tights and boots, but I have it here now with the matching culottes because it would be rude not to. I'm sorry, but Maasai designed it this way. I'm going to wear it this way. And I love it this way because I definitely am more of a separates girl, I think, than a dress. Although it's definitely calling to me dresses this year. And if it is a dress, I like it longer. And for wintertime, maybe a bit of wool, a la the Just Female. That's definitely my type of dress, where I don't have to think about anything else. So there's no belt, you know, the sleeves are long, so everything else is covered. I just have to add on my shoes. Love that kind of a dress. But separates, they just go so far in your wardrobe, don't they? You know, so I would definitely be able to wear these culottes with either of the jumpers I showed you. You know, I had tried all this on together as well, but just to kind of fit it into the Try On Tuesday, I wanted to kind of break it down and show you those pieces separately. So, like, easy peasy, even with a white shirt, I would do the culotte, and I would definitely do black in there as well. Like, I've got one left in the Inwear check coat as well, so you could have a nice mix of darker greys with black and lighter greys, you know, so there's so much scope for versatility. So just to tell you, the dress is 159. I'm in the small. I would definitely fit extra small either, and I would be like an 810 on top. It's got a little bit of room with the arms there. So it just depends, you know. I think take your normal size because it's A-shaped tight. So if you're a 12, go for the medium. If you're a 10, go for the small. If you're a 14, go for the large, and so on. In the culotte, I am also in the small, and these are 139, and I'm going to say they are exactly the same fabric content. Yes, they are 50-50 wool and polyester. The culotte actually has side pockets as well. Now, you don't really see them and you don't really use them when you're wearing them with the dress over it, but kind of nice to know they're there, especially for the later looks that I'm going to do with separates. It's just a flat elasticated waistband, nice and thick, not going to roll back, you know, just easy peasy. No pockets on the bum, just pockets on the side. So a nice kind of flush silhouette. They're so nice. They're great length. They're coming just to the top of my trainers, the high tops. So it would work really, really well with a sock boot. Would also work with a knee boot. If you find culottes are sometimes awkward, you find that length is a bit tricky to dress, especially if you are taller. I know sometimes the culottes hit you maybe at a strange place on your leg, and then you're left with a gap of your own leg before you reach the boot. So I would definitely urge you to go for a sock boot in that case, because that nice tight material will hold the leg, hug the leg, and you want it to come up. Even if you got it to come up to the knee, it would be ideal, because then you wouldn't have to add socks or anything. Again, I just have my bare leg here underneath, but in the winter, I would add in a grey sock here just to keep that line. Even if it was freezing, I might even be wearing my grey tights underneath, just depends on the day. Right now, it's still like 14 degrees, so randomly for the end of October. I'm just staying in bare leg, and I have socks on obviously with runners. But yeah, I like that really nice length. They're really comfortable here, like lovely, stretchy, as I said, and good bit of room in them. So, you know, they're loose and flowy. They're going to look great with those shorter length jumpers as well. And then also, if I'm doing my shirt, I'm going to do my side tuck on one side. Absolutely perfect. And I hope you agree, they work so nicely with the high tops. I just think this really cool kind of casual vibe with the sneakers in there. Oh, that detail at the back is just so nice. I've tied my trainers actually at the back this time. I don't know if you can see that. I hope you can. So I don't want the kind of messiness of a big load of loop at the front. Very, very rarely do I ever tie a lace-up boot in a knot at the front. It's sort of like the same concept as not tying my belt in the front. If I'm wearing a belt, it's off to the side, or it's at the back. So I think it's just best for me, because I'm not that tall. I don't want to break myself up that much. And because I have two layers going on here, another stop at the top of the boot with a big load of laces would not work. So just keeping it a nice little small tie at the back of the boot. Perfect. And then underneath, this is a great basic from Jane Lushka. So she does basics as well, or they do, should I say. It has the little JL logo here, which you don't see obviously underneath here. And this is organic cotton. So lovely on the skin. It's that kind of t-shirty material, you know, in a long sleeve turtleneck in bright white. So I'm kind of keeping all of the elements really fresh and bright here. Now, again, with grey, such a blank canvas, you could bring in creams here. You could do your oatmeal again. It would be stunning. And then you could bring in your Cooney boot if you bought it in Nubuck stone. Oh, yeah, I would totally do that as well. You could bring in navy, would be gorgeous with the grey, blues. Oh, it's like endless, isn't it? There's so many possibilities with this grey. Now, what should I do with my turtleneck? There it is. So the Jane Lushka, I'm in the size small, definitely a normal sizing. And as I said, it's 100% cotton and it's 55 euros. But there are other options in terms of turtlenecks as well. If you wanted to do something different. I just remembered. Yes. The bit of Kyrand yellow moss turtleneck as well would be stunning in here. And then you'd add in the cowl and the arm warmers, of course. There's your bit of black in there. So it's quite a harsh contrast. Brilliant if you are dark haired, you know, black hair, pale skin, or dark black skin and brown hair. Good with the darker colours mixed with the lighter colours. For me, I have to be careful. I can't have too much of a contrast. If I am doing the black underneath, I'm definitely doing black boots, and I'm probably adding in accessory like the Corona Silver necklace. So all the black sort of has a relationship with each other. If you wanted to not do bright white, there is a gorgeous turtleneck from Inwear, which is kind of more of a creamy white as an alternative. That will be good if you wanted to do your stone base. I could go on and on, like. And then as an accessory, I've added in a little necklace from Sandwich. These are great little beads. It's 49 euro in what they call dolphin color. So it's this kind of chalky gray, very, very light beaded necklace. And then on the end, you have this little snakeskin heart pendant. And then you have a couple of charms here in silver and this kind of lilac-y color. Another option, that purple and lilac would be beautiful in here as well. I love the length. And I love the shape, matching the shape of the V in the dress. I probably wouldn't add in a round piece here because it would fight with the neckline of the dress here. So, you know, if you've something round there, it'd be an awful lot going on, and it would cut across. So I would think, keep it V, keep it long. It'll work really nicely. And I want this kind of casual feeling in here as well because I'm still in the high tops. I would also use this beautiful piece from Corona Silver as well, which is again a kind of a grey, it's like a suede strand going down into a stone, which is this kind of pumicey colour, and then a silver pendant, and that one is 49 as well, so that would work just as nicely in here too. Ooh, that's really nice. But I think the darker pendant maybe I like with the boot because the contrast is the same. Anyway, there's options. Then finishing off the look, because of course I want to snuggle up with a beautiful scarf, and this one is sumptuous. It really is. This is 100% wool and it's so soft. It's a thick wool but not bulky. It's from Maasai and it's 69 euros. It is a long rectangle with tassels on the ends. So, I mean, in the reel and just in the photo attached to this video, I've literally just thrown it over the shoulders, shorter on one side and longer on the other, and then throw the other side over the shoulder. This I like because it kind of sits at the same length as the necklace. So you could wear it like that. I mean, scarves are so easy to style different ways. You throw it on you and see. Don't spend too long, you know. It's better to be kind of effortless about it. My usual way is grabbing the ends, wrapping it around the back of the neck, and getting all the material in the front. I love that really like wrapped up cozy look. And then my tassels are kind of underneath here. And then this is the way that's really easy to add on your coat on top. So that you, because you've no bulk anywhere around the arms and the shoulders. Ta-da! Love this grey tone with the underground colour in the sneaker as well, because it, again, tops and tails, brings balance and proportion into the look. So I think I have covered everything. I would love to hear your feedback. If you're able in the comments to tell me if you want me to answer any other questions. Usually I obviously talk about the fit, what size I'm in, the fabric content, you know, what colors I might put with things. I'm trying to think of other styling advice that you might like to hear. So let me know. I would love to hear if you think of any other questions, ask me. And of course, please call into the shop. I'm here on the main street in Enniskerry Village, Tuesdays to Saturdays, 11 to 5. You can make an appointment. We still have a limit on numbers, probably going to 3 in the shop at one time after hopefully the regulations change tomorrow, is it? I don't even know. Today, because it's Tuesday. So if you are really wanting to focus on, you know, shopping, getting a really couple of outfits or one great look, or you have something you want to try and color match, probably best to make an appointment so that you're not disappointed and you're waiting outside. Because if there's already two people here, I have to hold you back for a little while, you know what I mean? You can of course drop in and take a chance. Oftentimes that works really well. So it's up to you. Get in touch if you do want to reserve a time slot. And you're not obligated to buy anything, by the way. You can just come in and browse. You don't, just because you make an appointment doesn't mean you have to buy anything, of course not. So hopefully all options there for you. Okay, thank you so much for watching. As ever, it is always a pleasure to hear your positive feedback on these videos. I love filming them. I have loads more to show you. So much stock, inundated with stock this year. So there'll be plenty more to come. All right, thanks again, and I'll talk to you soon.